Hi, this is Tim, and I decided to make a short little, a mini review of the Sony NEX-5. And you're probably saying, well, wait a second, this camera's been out on the market for a while now. There's plenty of reviews and videos, you know, demonstrating the camera. And that's true, and my reason really is because I've used the camera now for about a year. And I really don't want to give a review or talk about a camera unless I actually used it and given it quite a workout, I guess you could say. So I'm not going to go over all the specs. There's plenty of videos and plenty of websites where you can find out about the Sony NEX-5. I really just want to go over my impression of it and a couple issues that I've had with the camera. First off, it's a great camera. I love the size, I love the features, the quality of the images. You know, I really don't have any complaints there. I think it's a camera that is very versatile. I've used it in almost every situation you can imagine. I've used it, you know, in California on the beaches, to sailing, and to out in Florida. I've taken it down the Grand Canyon, on top of the Empire State Building. I've used it at political events and rallies and protests where I've been covering, and I've used it on road trips across the country in really different climates, and it's worked well. It's taken great photos and video. I like the size. I like the quality of the workmanship, although there are a couple things that I'll talk about in a second. I've had a lot of journalists and photographers ask me about it, what I think about it, since they're looking for maybe a backup camera or something they can carry that it's not as large as their other gear. So overall, I really like the camera. There are, however, two things that have bugged me about it that I haven't had resolved yet, and hopefully Sony will resolve it in current versions of this camera and later versions. First off is the screen, the display screen. I haven't abused the camera or rubbed it against things. The only time the screen's really touched anything is going in and out of a camera bag. However, it scratches very easily, and I guess Sony puts an anti-glare film or coat on the screen, but it scratches off really easy, and you can see right around all the edges. It's just scratchy, and the problem with that is when you're outside in sunlight, or a bright light, it's really hard to see what you're filming or photographing. And I've seen on a lot of forums, people have talked about how you probably need to get a protector or something to cover it. That's great to know, but you know, it doesn't help you once the screen's already scratched. And if it does require some sort of protective coating or plastic or something, I think Sony should provide that. You know, if they're going to send us or give us a camera where the screen scratches off really easily like this, and they need to protect it somehow. Frankly, though, I think that, you know, it shouldn't scratch like that. I've got a cell phone that I've had for a couple years now with a large screen like this. It goes in and out of my pockets. You know, it takes a lot more abuse than this screen, and it looks brand new. It doesn't have any scratches on it. So there seems to be a problem with their anti-glare or coating that's scratching very easily. The other issue I've had is with the camera overheating. Like I said, I've used this in all sorts of situations. And I live in Arizona where it's very hot. But it's actually overheated when I've been in cool climates or cooler areas. And it's an annoyance, you know, if I'm taking a lot of photos and all of a sudden the camera starts to get hot, or I'm taking video and a little message pops up on the screen saying that it's overheating and that it's going to shut down or needs to shut down. And so, you know, you can lose a lot, or you can all of a sudden won't be able to film something you were hoping to film. And that happened to me recently when I was back at Kennedy Space Center filming the final launch of the space shuttle. I was there for the space shuttle Atlantis on its final launch. And we were in a big, large air-conditioned tent, very cool inside, and we had a lot of speakers, a lot of astronauts and guest speakers speaking to us. And I was filming their speeches, And one speech in particular was an astronaut, one of the first to fly on the space shuttle, and I really wanted it, and halfway through that speech, the camera overheated and it shut itself off, and so I lost that speech. So, you know, I know it's a small size and everything as far as the body, and it has a large battery, but it shouldn't overheat. It should be designed somehow where it won't overheat, you know, even after continuous use for long periods of time. But other than those two issues, that's really, I can't think of anything else that I have fault with this camera. And I would recommend it. I know they just came out with the 5N and the NEX-7, which look like great cameras, and hopefully in those cameras they have resolved these issues. So I would recommend this camera for anybody looking for a really good quality camera. And it's hopefully, if I get a new one soon or whenever I do, that it won't have these same issues. Thank you.